Does anyone have any questions?
Virginia Phillip teaches her passion, which means in her class there's a lot of swirling, sniffing, sipping, and spitting.
You have such an interesting job.
It is very interesting. I'm very lucky.
So you're simply going to look for nose palate, food and wine pairing.
Virginia teaches a 16-week wine course at the Breakers Resort on Palm Beach. But this is just a small part of her job. That's crystal clear. Virginia is the master sommelier here.
A sommelier's job is to actually stock a wine cellar and to give suggestions to guests. So at this particular hotel, my position is to buy wine for the entire hotel and make selections and create, I think it's 13 wine lists that I write here for the hotel.
That's a pretty big job.
Yes, it's a great job, but it's a big job.
In fact, Virginia oversees 28,000 bottles in the resort's wine collection.
How difficult is it to manage such a huge collection?
As it gets larger, it becomes definitely more challenging, for sure.
I was invited to take a tour of one of the cellars.
How is it organized?
It's organized by categories. So
on the wine list, Merlot, Pinot Noir, Chardonnay. The selections are endless. And the prices?
We sell our bottles anywhere from $36, and our most expensive is $15,000. So.
$15,000?
Right.
What makes a bottle of wine cost $15,000?
Well, it's rare, so there's not that much of it around. A particular vintage that was extremely successful for one particular harvest can certainly escalate the price of the bottle.
When you're dealing with a bottle of wine that's $6,000, do you get nervous when you're
sometimes,
pouring it?
Sometimes, definitely.
Dropping a bottle could cost a pretty penny, but sometimes you can't help but have a shaky hand.
It's cold in here.
Yeah, it's 55 degrees, so when you're spending an immense amount of time in here, I pull out a winter coat.
An impressive job that is not one in a million. Only 16 women worldwide hold the title Master Sommelier. Virginia earned it in 2002 after a grueling accreditation and exam process.
I try not to think about it. To me, it's just, it was my moment, it was my day, and I was able to pass the exam, and that's great.
That same year, Virginia was named the best sommelier in America.
Is it different being a woman in this industry?
Because there are so few of us, we're certainly have a little bit more attention drawn to us. Supposedly, we have better olfactory senses. We're supposed to be able to smell things a lot better, so that certainly helps us with tasting.
Being a woman in a man's world doesn't always fit everyone's taste.
It can be challenging at times. I've definitely had guests in this restaurant who have asked to see the sommelier after I've come and said, no, I'm looking for the man.
This is chorizo oil and a pork cuisson.
Okay, so this is going to be an entree, correct?
Give Virginia a glass of wine from anywhere in the world and likely she can pinpoint the origin.
The beauty of the pairing is to try and make sure that the wine